months. So I hope
you
all are excited. So for the today's flight, the pilot is Spandana. Over to you, Spandana.
Hello, everyone. So as you know, today we are going to France. So you have all written your facts, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, so you can all, we will give you an opportunity to say all those facts after this presentation, okay?
Okay.
So let's see about what about the France. So France is one of the largest countries in Europe. So France is in a continent of Europe and it shares boundaries with Germany, Belgium, Luxembourg, Switzerland, Italy, and Spain. So France is the most popular tourist destination in the world. There are many reasons, like it has a diverse culture, beauty, and amazing climate, and also outdoor recreational activities. And do you know, France is called as gateway to Europe because it has several major international airports, which you can go to France and visit all those other places. So some facts, even I have some facts today. Okay, so the official name is French Republic. Capital city is Paris. Population is about 6 crore. And official language is French. Money or currency is euro. Major mountain ranges is Alps, Pyrenees, and Massif Central. Major rivers are Seine, Rhine, and Rhône. So the capital city, Paris, is the third most visited country. So it's very popular for tourism. Yes, Abir?
Can I show you where France is?
Yeah, if you have something, what do you have?
A map.
Oh, yeah, show it to us. Okay. That's Alaska.
Wait.
Okay. Everybody can see it, yeah. Right? Yes, France. You can see the Eiffel Tower over there, right? Yeah. That's great, Abir. That's really great. You have a very good map, actually. It represents very nicely. Okay. So shall we move now? So few more details. So 85% of population is Roman Catholic, that they have the religion as Roman Catholic, and French and English are the two most widely spoken languages. France uses euros. I told you, right, the currency is euros. So if you go to France, you have to exchange your currency. So do you know what is 1 euro equal to how much rupee in India? Anyone? Arhan, do you know?
No, ma'am, I don't know.
Okay, so 1 euro is almost 87 rupees, okay?
There is 87 rupees?
Yes, 1 euro. So, I have a question for you. How do you say hello in French?
Hola? Sorry, no.
No, hola is in different language. Anyone? Any guesses? Okay, let me tell you. It's bonjour.
Bonjour.
Yes.
So to say
hello is bonjour. Okay. So, and in France, especially if you're going to meet any new person or any person, in fact, you start with bonjour so that they will feel respected and friendly towards you. Okay. Without bonjour, if you just directly go and speak, they don't take it very kindly. So you have to say bonjour first. Something like you say namaste, right? But it's not compulsory over in India. But bonjour is something like they feel friendly towards you if you say bonjour. Okay. So about the flag of France. It's tricolor flag, vertical lines of blue, white, and red. So blue represents truth and loyalty, white represents peace and honesty, and red means bravery and strength. So this is a map of France. It's a little animated one, but they show some major cities. Like if you see, you can see Paris over here, which shows Eiffel Tower, Strasbourg, which is famous for honey, and Bordeaux, which is famous for the wine they have, like that. Okay, So these are the major cities. So the national animal is Gallic rooster. You know the rooster, right? You have seen all the roosters before. So it's very famous, and it's also connected to Christianity in France, actually. Since because you can see rooster sculptures on top of the churches in France. It is believed that like Jesus, the rooster announces the coming of light after darkness and chases away the devils of the night while inviting good things associated with light. That's why they have their national animal as Gallic rooster. So let's speak about the culture and people of France. France is one of the oldest nation on earth and is most ethnically diverse country in Europe. So because there are so many cultures mixed with France, okay? So they are very broad influences, like from Spain also, from Italy also. That's why they are very diverse, and including cuisine, winemaking, politics, philosophy, film, music, etc. They're very famous for fashion also. Let's speak about the cuisines. So have you heard that French cuisine is very famous? Have you heard few cuisines from France?
No, ma'am.
No? Okay, let me show you. Okay, French cuisine is developed and influenced by cultures like Spain, Italy, Switzerland, Germany, Belgium. And they also have their own varieties. And cheese and wine are the major part of the cuisine. French wines are very famous. And knowledge of French cooking has been contributed significantly to Western cuisine. Even when the Western cuisines, they look up to French cuisines a lot. Their culinary education, that is the education about how to make food and all those things, it's very famous. The French food is known for its flavor and elegance. It is a combination of rich, natural flavor coming together. So let me show you one of the dish. This is called as coquabin. And it's a chicken braised with wine and mushroom. It's a very, very popular dish. And the name translates as rooster in wine. Okay. The next one is ratatouille. Can you see this? It's a very interesting shape, right? It is one of the iconic dishes of France. Yes, there is a movie named Ratatouille, actually. That is because ratatouille is like a vegetable. It's like, do you see the design, how it's shaped? Excuse me, but can you hear some noise from my side?
No, ma'am.
No, right? Okay, then it's fine, because some construction is going on. Sorry about that. Okay, so how
it's done? Here also there is construction.
Okay, so ratatouille is basically in movies and all, they say it because something like mixed up or confusion like that, they say ratatouille. So because it is shaped like this, it's very famous. It's a vegetable fried dish then baked in an oven. So that's how it is arranged. That's why it's famous. Okay, you can see it in very famous high-end restaurants in India and all, ratatouille. So about Paris, what do you know about Paris? What is famous in Paris?
Ma'am, Eiffel Tower is very famous in the Paris.
Yes, it is. And anything else? Do you know what Paris is called as?
Capital of France.
Yes, it is the capital of France. And it's also a very popular city in the world. It's called a city of love because of the Eiffel Tower, actually. It's a major European city, and like Eiffel Tower and also 12th century Gothic Notre Dame Cathedral, that is a very famous monument. City is known for its culture and designer boutique, especially fashion. Yes, Aran?
That it is estimated in how much population?
That I'm not sure, actually. I think 1 million or something.
Yes, ma'am. Like
yes,
that.
Arika, you have raised your hand.
Yes, ma'am. I don't want to share anything, but I just want to know, why was this Eiffel Tower made?
I will show you. I will tell you about that, okay? So, okay. Paris is also very, very famous for fashion. Have you heard of Paris Fashion Week? That happens every year. It's a very, very popular show. And people from across the world come over there to visit the fashion shows where topmost designers go and present over there. Okay, so here comes Eiffel. Yes?
Ma'am, can I tell the famous food of Paris?
Yes, yes. Sure.
Ma'am, it's cheese, onion soup, macarons, steak, tartare, and more.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, cheese and wine is like famous all over France, and Paris is like the center of the France, right? So it's pretty popular over there. So Eiffel Tower. So it's a wrought iron lattice tower, which is made up of iron basically in Paris. And it is named after the engineer Gustave Eiffel. He is the one who is the engineer. That's why they named it as Eiffel Tower. His company itself designed and built this tower. So as you asked, Arika, Eiffel Tower was built because they had a world fair like you have, right, fairs in countries also where many things come in, like stores and playing and all. Do you remember the fairs? So like that, they had a world fair. They had people coming from all over the world. That's why they wanted to make something for as an opening for that fair, like. So they made this Eiffel Tower just for that purpose, and it's now a world famous monument. So that's how Eiffel Tower was built. Okay, did you understand, Arika?
Yes, ma'am, thank you.
Okay, so the next one is French Riviera. It's a Mediterranean coast of southeastern France. It includes famously glamorous beach resorts such as Saint Tropez and Cannes, and an independent microstate of Monaco. If you have heard of Cannes, it's a famous for Cannes Film Festival also, where many films are broadcasted over there for winning prizes, and many stars go over there also. So French Riviera is also famous for its weather because it gets 300 days of sun in a year, making it very sunny and beachy place to visit. So this is the Eiffel Tower at night. And this is a French Riviera. So one more place is Arc de Triomphe. It means triumphal arch of star, which honors the heroes of French Revolution and Napoleonic Wars. I'll tell you about French Revolution a little bit, okay? It's also called as Revolution of 1789. This revolution was done because they wanted to end the ancient ruling of how the country was ruled. So to end this, French Revolution happened. And Napoleonic War was a war of French with other European powers. This was headed by Napoleon the King. Have you heard of the king named Napoleon?
No, ma'am.
Okay, he is a very, very famous king. So you might learn in your history classes in the further years, I think so. Okay? So he was the one headed this war. So the next one is famous cities in France. First, obviously, is Paris. It's a capital city, one of the most famous cities in the world. Second one is Dijon. It's famous for a beautiful architecture and hosts international fairs yearly, where about 200,000 people visit. Okay. From here, the name Dijon mustard. Have you heard of this Dijon mustard? They use in burgers and all those things, salads and all. So this was originated here. That's why it's famous as a Dijon mustard. Okay, the next one is Lyon. It's the third largest city of France and also second most populated city of France. It is a major center for banking, chemicals, and pharmaceutical industry. And the fourth one is Lille. It's on Dyle River, also it's near the border of Belgium. It's a cultural hub and bustling university city, and it is an important merchant center. That means many merchants are here in France. So one of the zoos are very famous over here. It's called as La Palmière Zoo. This place is located in Les Mathis near Royan in southwestern France, and it attracts 700,000 visitors each year, and it has 1,600 animals with 115 species. Let me show you some animals, okay? So, do you know which animal is this?
Wolf?
Striped hyena?
No. It's an African wild dog, actually. It's called as African... Yes?
I know this.
Okay. Do you know any facts about it?
Well, nothing really. Okay, just know the name.
Okay. So, it's very famous for how they hunt, right? They are very, very well coordinated. So, they go in a pack, they are coordinated, and that's why it's very good at hunting also. And female African dog actually sometimes gives birth to 20 babies at a time. So, 10 is like they usually give it, but 20 is also they can birth that 20 babies at a time. Okay.
Wow.
Yes, that's a lot, right? Okay.
So, the next one?
Yes, next one.
Meerkat.
Oh, yes. Meerkat. Correct. Do you know, have something to say about this?
Actually, I love these cuties.
Yeah, it's cute, right?
So, but actually, they are not cats.
Okay, that I didn't know about. That's great to know. So they mainly eat insects and they dig out of the ground. Did you know that?
Yes, ma'am, I knew that. Oh. I have a book full of animals.
Oh, that's great. That's great. We have too many animal enthusiasts this time here. That's good to know. So what is this? Oh, you all
How
must
can I tell about
gorilla.
Gorilla.
Yes, it's gorilla. But Rohita, you have something to say?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Meerkats are highly intelligent.
Okay, that's good. Okay, as you all said, this is gorilla. Okay, gorilla. A male gorilla can weigh up to 200 kgs sometimes also. So this one. Do you know any?
You know how much it can live?
Which one? Gorilla?
Yeah, ma'am. It can live up to 35 to 50 years.
Oh, that's a long time.
And the weight is, you know how much?
Yeah, it weighs up to 200 kg, right?
Ma'am, that looks like a reptile. 200 kg.
It is 135 to 275 kg and 300 to 590 pounds.
Okay. That's good.
Is this a monitor
looks or like a reptile? It looks like a reptile.
Yes, it is a reptile. It's a green iguana.
I'm going to say iguana only.
Yeah.
So it looks like it.
Yes, they're of lizard family and they eat mainly leaves and fruits. And they can be found in all continents except Antarctica. Okay. So this one.
Cobra.
Python.
It's a Central American boa actually. Arica.
Oh,
yes,
I know
Arica.
This.
Arica. Boa. I know it's a snake family. So.
Yes, but before that, Arica has raised her hand. Yes, Arica.
Ma'am, I was asking that where is that green iguana lived? I couldn't hear.
Green iguana can live everywhere actually, except Antarctica. They don't live over there.
Antarctica.
Okay, yeah.
Okay.
So as I was saying, this is Central American boa. They actually do not have poison in them. They just suffocate their prey and kill them, and then they swallow. Okay.
They are not able to breathe once it constricts, and their blood flow cuts.
Yes.
Out.
Yes. Correct. That's how it kills. Yes. Okay. So moving on, Alps. You have heard of this mountain range, right? It's the highest mountain range that lies entirely in Europe, and it stretches across 8 countries actually: France, Switzerland, Monaco, Italy, Liechtenstein, and Austria, Germany, and Slovenia. This alpine region has a strong cultural identity because people have traditional culture of farming, cheese making, woodwork, etc. And Mount Blanc is the highest peak in this Alps, and it's spread across 3 countries. This is Mount Blanc. It provides drinking water, irrigation, and hydroelectricity power to Europe, actually. So, moving on. This is the French airline Air France. This is the flag bearer. That is national airline of France. Their tagline is France is in the air. So, little bit of about Air France is they were formed in 7 October 1933. And they are stylized as Air France is a flag carrier of France, and its headquarters is Tremblay in France. So I have a video to show you. Let me show that, share that. Okay.
He answered.
Okay. Who wants to share their facts now?
Before you start,
yeah,
sharing facts.
Yes, Abir.
I think the name Nice is a very funny thing, despite the name that Nice is this kind of.
Yes, actually, when I first saw also, it was very fascinating to me. Even I wanted to share it. Then I completely forgot that it was a place in French Riviera. It's a very famous place, actually. And I didn't even know about that before, that Nice is a name of a place. It is funny. Okay, Arhan, you can start.
Okay, ma'am. Yes, ma'am, I'm starting. First fact is that France is the most visited country in the world, and France welcomed 84 million foreign tourists in 2013, and in the French are expecting to increase the people coming. And second one is, after Germany, France has the largest population in EU nations, and 85% of its population lives in Arabian Seas. Third one is, however, other language there are more than 5 million people of Arab and African living in France. In the past, France is a colony where people come from various countries. Yes, ma'am.
That's good to know. And even Paris is the third most visited country in the world, actually, next to Thailand and London, I think. That's how. Or Bangkok and London, I think. But Paris is the third most visited country in the world. So that's good to know the facts.
It's not country, it's city.
Sorry, I forgot. Yes, it's a city. Thank you, Abhi. That's
ma'am, good. May I tell one fact about Paris?
Yes.
Ma'am, in the Paris, there are very historical museums.
Yes. There are very famous museums, actually. And many famous sculptures also over there. And also the art are present over there. Any others who wants to share the facts?
What I said, na, EU, that is Europe.
It's a European Union. EU means European Union.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Rohita, do you have any facts written or anything?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, please do go and do say.
Ma'am, France is the world's most popular tourist destination. French was the official language of England for about 300 years.
Correct. Yes, and then it became English.
And it is, the French love their cheese.
Yes, that they do. Because they are also very famous for that, right? So anyone else who has to say? Ansh?
Ma'am, I have told the facts already.
Oh, you have? Oh, all right. Arika, do you have something to say? Oh, Arika has left, I think. Prakhar? Rabir, nothing. Do you have anything?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So tomorrow we are visiting Germany.
Germany.
All right. So you just look up the word how to say hello in Germany. Okay. German language.
It means hallo.
Okay. You already know that. You have been to Germany, right?
No, I've been to US, but I know a bit of German.
Oh, that's great. Then you have to say a few words tomorrow.
My father has gone to Germany, France, US and Austria.
Oh, that's great. Okay.
So Amma, are you going to meet US?
Sorry, what, Rohita?
Are we gonna meet US?
Yes, after a long time. Like US is in a, we are going according to alphabetical order. Okay. So since Prakhar knows about few words in German, tomorrow he will say few words in German. Okay. He will teach us. All right, Prakhar?
Sure, ma'am.
Okay, that's great. Let's meet tomorrow then. Bye.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am. Have a nice day.
Same to you. Bye, ma'am. Have a nice day.